All right, we have two rules to the show. Rule number one, see anything inside the show that you like, clap your hands. Rule number two, see anything inside the show that you guys do not like, clap your hands. I have a knock-knock joke. When I say knock-knock, everyone says who's there. Knock-knock. Philip. Fill up the bucket with your money. So if you enjoy the show, let us know. What time is it?
Showtime.
Here we go. That's the 1-2. You hear me? You hear me? All right, go on.
They hear you. Man, what really made me want to... Man, I think... I need a little change in my life. I was doing choreography for some time. I wanted a little change, and I saw breakdancing. I would come downtown.
You saw what?
Down there, breakdancing.
Who?
Breakdancing. B-boy.
Okay.
Actually, B-boy, and I seen it on like tape and whatnot before I even seen them performing downtown or whatnot. Yeah. I seen it on tape. I seen it on little flicks and whatnot on the computer and whatnot. And you know, after a while, I kind of got really interested in it. And then I heard that they perform downtown, the same type of dancing, b-boying and whatnot. So started going downtown to see the show. You know, at the time I was about 17. I started going downtown, and I just liked it so much. I just kept going back, just about almost every single day. Every single day watching these guys perform, you know, different parts of Manhattan. Just kept going back, trying to find them. And then I would eventually we find them. We just stay there and watch the show. And I was just like, wow, like I want to do it. That's what I want to do. But it wasn't an easy transition for me. But after a few months, my body kind of got used to it and got stronger from lifting my weight. And I got used to my weight, so it wasn't easy. But after a few months, the style got easy for me. It got easy for me after a few months.
Now you make money doing it.
Yeah. You know, it's basically how I make a living right now, me personally. You know what I mean? Speaking for self, this is basically how I make a living. And I have no other way right now or other source of getting money. This is how I get my money right now. On the streets, working almost every single day.
How long you been with crew?
About a year and a half.
You guys are how many times a week?
Man, I say about 5 times, 6 times a week. Yeah. And if we really grind it like how we grind it right now, because if you don't grind,
you don't shine. We
grind
right
now.
We not shining. We
so
grinding.
So that's about
right
7 times out of the week, brother.
Got to go from Monday.
7 times out of the week.
Monday to Monday.
Man,
trying to make it happen.
And it ain't easy. Hustling,
every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm every day I'm hustling, 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 hustling.
Started back in the days, the family, you know what I'm saying? That's how I got involved. This is Uncle Hobie, right here. And my father, Universal.
Dynamite.
You know what I'm saying? His name is Dynamite.
Dynamite.
Call him, you know. He do the cigarette trick. That's how I basically got involved with the streets. As in dancing on the street, we call it hitting. Performing for money. It's called hitting. If you ain't no hitter, you ain't no hitter. You know what I'm saying? It's the difference between hitting and b-boying. A lot different. Hitting is a street dancer. B-boying is a studio dancer.
Do you consider performing on the street a hustle, job, a career?
Well, fun. Depends how you put it. Because I do it for fun. It's a fun thing for us to do to get money at the same time. So why not do it? like some of the older guys, they really like live off of dancing on the street. I think everybody love hitting that shit. Cause if it wasn't for hitting, a lot of things they wouldn't have. They don't have jobs. They don't have no boss when they hit.
What's your main source of income right now?
The truth? Welfare. I want you to see my eyes when I say that. Welfare. Food stamps, stuff like that. Plus hitting is the most though. But welfare. We love welfare. You know what I'm saying? But hitting is the most, like, it's the most best thing. The most money, you know what I'm saying? The most fun, basically. And you just showing your talent. It's like free money.
Is it hard in New York?
Oh, it's definitely hard in New York, because after the World Trade Center fell, we get big crowds, so the police, like, harass us. But the police just harass us because they harass us. Because they just don't like break dancers. Because there's too many of us in New York. And I guess they just don't like us.
One saying Lee drinks a lot, smoke a lot, flop a lot.
Flop a lot? Flop a lot, Chris?
Flop. Slacking off.
I'm gonna flop for you.
Now I'm just saying, now that's what they want me to do. In this neighborhood, New York, people show me love, people don't show me love no more. They don't want to show the dance, they don't want to know where this come from. They just look at you and leave. You're doing something better than ourselves. We ain't selling drugs or nothing. We dancing, leave. People look at us like, oh, we just dancing. And what? People don't look at us as if we dancing. And we try to make a living.
99 years been doing this. Like, a friend of mine's used to live around my way in the Bronx. Mommy, he moved, he used to do it. You know what I mean? He told me about it. So, you know what I mean? So he used to practice in the hallway. So one day I just came down with him. I like what he did, so he started breaking me down. 42nd Times Square. There's a lot of people who's like, want to practice to be the best, but ain't no best. You can't be, is another person, it's like, it's gonna go, somebody gonna be better than you. So, whoever, it goes on and on. So, whoever, if you think, like me, if I think I'm the best one, I'm not. It's a lot of people. It's down to rapping, DJ, anything. Yeah, you could be one of the best, but not the best. Hip hop never stops, it keeps going and going. And it gets better and better. If you know where you're from, you know where it comes from. Comes from the street.
I feel like everybody that's in my group love what they do. It's a lot of conflict around that because we perform for money and whatnot. So it's a lot of conflict around, is it just for the money or is it for the love?
For the love.
But you gotta love it before you can do anything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Not everybody love what they do. And with some dancers, period, or performers or hitters or B-boys or breakers, not everybody love what they do. You know what I'm saying? Right. Some do stuff for different reasons, to get better, to get girls, to stay in shape. There's a lot of different reasons that you do it for, but I say the main reason that you should have it in your heart. You know what I mean? This is about trying to, you know what I mean, get a phone number. I don't know about no commercials and blowing up. You can get a phone number through the end of the day and not go to jail, get arrested, you're good.
I'm just happy to be here. Face on camera now. I ain't a star yet, working on that.